Good afternoon, my people. How are you there? All right, quick one. I just want to say something about the video I posted yesterday. Rev Ntia, about what he said against Obi Cubana. Yes. The man don't come apologize, say he made a mistake. That he didn't. Before I even talk, Muma, I just play the video show now. So, Muna, I just watch before I make comments.
Okay. On Sunday, now, when I was preaching, I made some comments about a burial that was carried out. And yesterday, somebody sent me a clip of an interview that the man carried out with BBC. And in further reflection, those comments were very, very harsh and unkind. Those comments did not reflect his heart at all. Those comments did not reflect his attitude. Also, it turns out that he's my in-law. My wife is from Anambra State, and he's from Anambra State. So in further reflection, I want to say that the comment came out very wrong and totally prematurely. With further information, the lives that the man has affected, the people that the man has lifted, the destinies that he has invested in, praise the Lord. So I want to say sincerely, it is not my intention as a preacher to preach to cause hurt or to cause pain or to preach to discredit anybody at all. As a preacher, my assignment is to preach words that heal, not hurt. Words that help, not harm. Praise the Lord. And so therefore, in any way that those comments might have caused harm or hurt or pain, especially in the time of grief or burying a loved one, I sincerely apologize for such comments that came out of place, came very wrong. And I want to say that in any way, that man is a great man. With the things he has done, he's a great man. In any way that those comments might have hurt or pained Obi Cubana or his family, which are my in-laws, or his friends, please, from this preacher's heart, with all humility, I sincerely apologize for those comments. And I want to say that with the quality of person that I have come to see he is, he has my respect 100%. We need more of such people who have a heart for others and will go to great extents to invest in others. I want to say that any negativity that might have been perceived or received or interpreted is totally regretted, and I apologize for that. And I want it to be on record that I could have said it privately, but I need to say it publicly because I made that statement publicly so that people will know that it's possible to say something wrong. And when you do so, you should be humble enough to publicly apologize. It does not reduce you, and it doesn't take anything away from you. Praise the Lord. And so I want to personally apologize to Obi Cubana and his family and all his friends and any other person that might have been hurt or pained by such harsh words. Please, sincerely, let God also touch your heart to know that it was never the intention of this preacher. Here, we don't pull anybody down.
All right, quick one. Now, all those papa children, that is your children, well, when I thought, say, waiting when our pastor talk was not bad, that he had a point of saying what he said, that is right. You will be defending pastor because he's your own pastor. If it's another pastor, you will stand against. I don't know, Christianity is something else that they are not doing Christianity based on your pastor. Understand? Now, this man don't accept his fault. So you people will be pastor that if you say what he said was right. Now you people even fear pastor now. They don't even have the fear of God. See, this life you can only respect pastor. You don't have to fear pastor because they are made like you. They are ought to do mistakes. Understand? So when they do mistakes, it's opportunity for you to tell them that your pastor, this thing you are saying you are doing is not right. By so doing, you help them to correct their mistake. Because it, now that pastor go church say is yeah the smell. Everybody church hell and understand. If me personal or other people did not come out to say no pastor what you said is bad, that man for not accepting mistake, and by so doing for convince other people not to help people or spray money, then go say made them go build road. But now that man don't go no say what he said was not good. He came out and apologized. You know why? Now what's your lesson now? Say pastor they know be God, then they do mistakes. So why would not they fear to talk, say then good you and touch not my anointed and do my prophet no harm? We are also prophet of God. Understand? Not be insult to tell pastor what you are doing is not good. Not be insult. If your pastor do something that is not good, instead of you to go and backbite him, some of you will even go and backbite your pastor, but in the public you stand with him, in the back you backbite. It's an opportunity for you to just the same way you go to his office and say, daddy, I need counsel. Don't go to the office and counsel your pastor. Tell your pastor, daddy or mommy or all this thing you said or you do, I think is not good. You use your Bible to back it up. You open his eyes to understand what he did that was not good. But you people now, is daddy, my dad is right. Anything he said, I stand with my pastor. You don't stand with God anymore. You stand with your pastor. Are you normal? No, are you normal? Now when the man don't come apologize, your conscience not supposed blame you. Who be mumu? Now you come be the yeye we come smell, because yesterday you were just smelling on social media. Come they talk nonsense, so you not supposed talk. But that man that has full sense and is a man of sense and responsibility, he now came out and apologized with a full video. And I respect that man, because some pastor will not take this decision, will not take this action of coming, being humble to apologize for a mistake that he committed. Understand? But that man humble himself. Pastor, Rev Ntia, I love you. This is what you do, eh? You should say, if to say, would they talk about bad governance in this Nigeria, eh? Things for the correct. Because if to say, the energy we will put for waiting you talk, would they carry and put for even state government or federal government, eh? You get something ready for the adjust, but people too, they keep quiet because they fear. Even the Bible tells you, he that tried to save his life will lose it. People fear pastor now. The fear of pastor is too much in this our society, in this generation, especially in Nigeria. But they don't even fear God. Do you know that some people will see their pastor, they will not want to sin, but if their pastor leave that place, they will sin. But they don't know it. They don't even fear God again. Pastor, Reverend Ntia, for coming out to apologize, first, we have accepted your apology. But secondly, please speak to your church member that they should also study the word of God so that when you go wrong, they can help you. Understand? I'm waiting, I get to talk with that. Okay, meanwhile, yesterday on my comment section, via the video I posted, over 50 people commented that they won't go back to the church, they won't attend the church, that they are leaving the church. Please, I'm begging you people, okay, go back to the church. This is the real man of God. For a man who has everything that takes to have pride or to live in pride, to come out and humble and apologize publicly, is a real man of God. Please go back to the church. We are all humans, ought to make mistakes. But we should have this sense of not fearing pastor, rather respect your pastor and fear God. Because if you fear God, you have the boldness to speak the truth. The Bible says, know the truth, and the truth shall set you free. So when you read your Bible, you study the word of God, you only respect your pastor. You will not fear your pastor. By so doing, you will help your pastor in time of trouble. Please, go back to the church. Go back to your activities. If you are usher, any position you are in that church, please. A lot of people were so bitter, as in angry with what they say. Please, go back and love your pastor. And I also, anytime I see to you, I'll worship there with him again. I love him. Thank you, sir, for coming out to say that you are a man. I like the way you put your English. Even some people will not understand, but all your English will see your apology. I apologize. We love it till you talk. If you share this video, Understand? Share this video, make people watch, so that those people where that got angry over his dead man against Obi Cubana. So if they watch this video, they will know that Rev Ntia is a real man of God that can humble himself and accept his fault. So please share this video, let the video go viral. Pastor Rev Ntia, we love you. We pray that God will give you the grace to see the right thing and do it, not like other men of God who you are.
Okay, no problem. God will see us.